Good morning, children. Class 8, subject chemistry, chapter 6, chemical reactions. So in this chapter, today we are going to learn chemical reaction, characteristics of a chemical reaction. What is a chemical reaction? You know that the changes that takes place in the universe are broadly classified into two types. One is a physical change and the one is a chemical change. What is a chemical change? What happens during a chemical change? So in a chemical change, a new substance will be produced. So during a chemical change, chemical reaction will take place. What is a chemical reaction? Chemical reaction means two or more substances react with each other under a set of conditions and it produces new substances. So that is a chemical reaction. So it is a change. Chemical reaction is a change that takes place when elements and compounds react with each other under different set of conditions to form a new product. So that is known as a chemical reaction. So let us take few examples. So look at the first example. Iron reacts with sulfur, produces iron sulfide. Both iron and sulfur are elements. So two elements react together and produces a compound iron sulfide. Look at the second example. Ammonia reacts with hydrogen chloride and produces ammonium chloride. So both ammonia and hydrogen chloride are compounds. So two compounds react to produce a new compound. And third example, zinc reacts with hydrogen chloride and produces zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. Okay, here zinc is an element, hydrogen chloride is a compound. So one element reacts with one compound and produces two new substances. The first one is zinc chloride, it is a molecule of a compound. And another one is a hydrogen, it is a molecule of an element. So you know what is a molecule of an element? Two same atoms. So same atoms combine together to produce a molecule of an element. Molecule of a compound means different kind of atoms will combine to produce a molecule of a compound. Okay. So these are the few examples of a chemical reaction. Now we will learn some terms related to chemical reaction. What is a reactant? The reactant or the substance which take part in a chemical reaction. So during a chemical reaction, two or more substances will react and produce a new substance. So they will react. So that's why they are called as reactants. The substances which take part in a chemical reaction are called reactants. And what is a product? So these are the substances that are formed as a result of a chemical reaction. So products are the new substances that are formed when reactants are react. So a new substance will be produced, that we say it as products. Okay, look at the example. Ammonia reacts with hydrogen chloride, produces ammonium chloride. So here ammonia and hydrogen chloride are the reactants. They two will react and produce a new substance which is called as a product. Here the product is ammonium chloride. Okay. And what happens to the properties of the products? Is the properties of the products are same with that of a reactant? No. The properties of the products are entirely different from those of the reactants. So the first example I have taken is hydrogen reacts with oxygen, produces water. It's a very simple reaction. Both hydrogen and oxygen are gases, we know, yes, and it produces water, which is a liquid. So the properties are different. Yes, hydrogen, you know, it forms the basis of the life. It's an exploding gas. Oxygen supports combustion and breathing process. Yes. But the properties of water are entirely different from those of hydrogen and oxygen. So it won't support, water won't support combustion or respiration process, breathing process. It won't explode. Yes. Therefore, the properties of the products are entirely different from those of the reactants. And second example, water reacts with carbon dioxide, produces glucose. And it also liberates oxygen gas. It's a photosynthesis process. So plants prepare its own food, you know. So it takes water and carbon dioxide and prepares its own food, starch, glucose, and it also liberates oxygen. So here, look at the properties of glucose. It's entirely different. It's sweet in taste, yes, glucose is sweet in taste, but it won't have the properties of water and carbon dioxide. So that, therefore, from this we conclude that the properties of the products are entirely different from those of the reactants. Okay. Now we are going to learn the characteristics of a chemical reaction. So few characteristics we are going to discuss today. Number one, breaking of a chemical bond. Number two, evolution of a gas. Number three, change in color. Number four, formation of precipitate. Number five, change of state. Number six, energy change. So we'll discuss one by one. The first one, breaking of the chemical bond. Okay, so let us take this example. Hydrogen reacts with oxygen and it produces water, you know. Yes, here what happens during this reaction, the bond between the hydrogen atom breaks. Also, the bond between the oxygen atom breaks. What is a bond? What is a chemical bond? A force of attraction between the two atoms. So that we say it is a chemical bond. How a chemical bond is formed? By the sharing or transfer of electrons. Either it shares the electrons or it transfers the electrons. So sharing of electron, transfer of electrons will produce a bond. Okay. We say those are a mere attraction. So force of attraction between the two atoms. So that is a chemical bond. So during a chemical reaction, what happens? The reactants, the atoms between two hydrogen atoms and two oxygen atoms, there is a bond between, there is an attraction between these two atoms will break it. So will break down and they will produce a new bond. A new bond between oxygen and hydrogen will be produced. So during this reaction, the bond between hydrogen atom break and the bond between oxygen atom will also broken down and a new bond will be formed between oxygen and hydrogen. So that's how a water is formed. So during a chemical reaction, breaking of an old bond will take place and also making of a new bond will produced. Okay. So breaking of a chemical bond is one of the characteristics of a chemical reaction. So look at this example. What happens? The bonds in the hydrogen and oxygen molecules are broken and the bonds between the oxygen and hydrogen atoms are newly formed to make a molecule of water. So the bond between hydrogen and oxygen are broken and a new bond will be formed between hydrogen and oxygen. So that happens during this chemical reaction. And evolution of gas. So in some reactions, a gas is evolved and they can be seen in the form of bubbles. We say those are called as effervescence. So bubbles, those are called as effervescence. So the same example I have taken, electrolysis of water. That means water broken down into hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. So how water is formed? When hydrogen and oxygen combine to produce water. Now if you pass electricity through water, it's broken down into hydrogen and oxygen gas. So you can see the bubbles here. Yes. So hydrogen gas is liberated and here oxygen gas is liberated. So in some reactions, the evolution of gas will takes place. So it is also one of the characteristics of a chemical reaction. And the gas evolved is indicated with an upward aromatic in the chemical reaction. So look at this example. Zinc reacts with sulfuric acid and it liberates hydrogen gas, and zinc sulfate is one of the product. So hydrogen gas is evolved. You can look at the bubbles. So the bubbles indicates the liberation of gas. And while writing a chemical equation, the liberation of gas is indicated with the help of an upward arrow mark. Okay. So within the bracket, we need to use an upward arrow mark to indicate that gas is evolved, gas is liberated. Okay. And the third one, change in color. So during a chemical reaction, some color change will take place. So some chemical reactions can be detected by a change in color. So copper carbonate is green in color when it gets decomposed. So it produces two products. One is copper oxide, another one is carbon dioxide. Copper oxide is black in color. So if we when we heat copper carbonate, it turns into copper oxide, which is black in color, and it also liberates carbon dioxide, which is a gas. So we'll enclose it with a upward arrow mark. Okay, children. So change in color will be detected during some chemical reaction. So it is also one of the characteristics of a chemical reaction. The next one is formation of precipitate. So what is a precipitate? A precipitate is an insoluble solid that separates out from a liquid or solution. So during two or more liquids will react, and an insoluble solid will separate out from those liquid. So that is a precipitate. Okay, a precipitate is an insoluble solid that separates out from a liquid. Here I have taken lead nitrate, which is colorless, and potassium iodide solution. So both of them are colorless. So when we mix together, potassium iodide and lead nitrate are mixed together, it produces two products. One of the product is a precipitate, lead iodide. So lead iodide is the product, it precipitates out, and one more product is potassium nitrate. You can see the yellow color precipitate. So precipitate is an insoluble solid. Okay, and it is indicated with a downward arrow mark. Within the bracket we need to use a downward arrow mark to indicate the precipitate. Okay, children. So precipitate, formation of precipitate, is also one of the characteristics of a chemical reaction. And energy change. So some reactions are accompanied by a change of energy. So during the reaction, energy change will take place, especially in the form of absorption or release of heat. So based on whether heat is absorbed, heat energy is absorbed, or heat energy is evolved, liberated, chemical reactions are classified into two types. One is exothermic reaction, another one is endothermic reaction. What is an exothermic reaction? A chemical reaction in which heat is given out is called an exothermic reaction. So calcium oxide, when it mixes with water, it produces calcium hydroxide. If we touch the test tube, we feel hot. That means heat is given out, heat is liberated. So to indicate the evolution of heat, we are using plus heat in the product side, because heat is liberated, so it should be indicated in the product side. So plus heat should be written on the product side. And what is an endothermic reaction? So it is a chemical reaction in which heat is absorbed. It is known as an endothermic reaction. So here nitrogen reacts with oxygen and produces nitric oxide. So heat is absorbed, so plus heat should be written on the reactant side, because the reactants absorb the heat and produces product. So if we touch the test tube, we feel cold, chillness will be felt, because heat is absorbed in this reaction. Okay, so during a chemical reaction, if heat is absorbed, we say those reactions are called as endothermic reactions. During a chemical reaction, if heat is liberated, released or given out, we say those reactions are called as exothermic reactions. Okay, children, thank you.